Hello bookish friends, welcome to my June wrap-up part 3. In this video, I will first of all talk about my monthly bookish statistics. In the second part of the video, I will wrap up how I did with my yearly reading challenges, as well as the monthly readathons that I participated in June. In the month of June, I read a total number of 13 books. I read 3 general fiction, 2 historical fiction, 2 mystery, 2 fantasy, 2 romance, 1 thriller and 1 non-fiction. I read a total number of 3,546 pages. I read 2 books less than 100 pages, 3 books between 100 and 200 pages, 3 books between 200 and 300 pages, 3 books between 300 and 400 pages, 1 book between 500 and 600 pages, and 1 book between 600 and 700 pages. My average page number per book amounted to 272.76 pages. I read one book published in 1800s, one book published in 1930s, 2 books published in 1960s, 1 book published in 1970s, 2 books published in 1980s, 1 book published between the years 2000 and 2009, 4 books published in 2010s, and 1 book published between the years 2020 and 2021. I read 10 books originally written in English, 2 books originally written in Turkish, and 1 book originally written in Japanese. I read the Japanese book in its Turkish edition. I read 4 novels, 2 novellas, 1 graphic biography, 1 short story and 1 short story collection. All of the 13 books that I read in the month of June was targeted towards adults. I read 7 e-books, 5 audiobooks and 1 hardback. I rated 2 books 6 out of 10, 6 books 7 out of 10, 4 books 8 out of 10 and 1 book 9 out of 10. My average rating for the month of June amounted to 7.31, which was very close to my monthly average rating. In 2022, I'm joining 2 yearly reading challenges. One of them is Series About Series, which is hosted by Lizzie Fay Loves Books. And for this readathon, I'm aiming to progress in 22 series. In the month of June, I read a quite number of books belonging to series. I started the Mouse Duology by reading Mouse Volume 1, A Survivor's Tale. I started and finished the Riley MacPherson Duology by reading The Broken String and The Silent Sister by Diane Chamberlain. Started The Warbreakers series by Brandon Sanderson. Because there's only one book in this series, which is the first book, Warbreaker, I am now up to date in this series. I'm also up to date in the Walton Valley series by Catherine Kennedy. I read The Preacher's Unexpected Wife, which is the second book in the series. And I started The Widow series by Fiona Barton. Lastly, I progressed in Lexie Baker series by reading Dying for Danish. The second yearly challenge that I'm doing is Golden Girls Reading Challenge, which is hosted by Rachel Fryman. In the month of June, the prompt was to read a book written by an LGBTQ author or about an LGBTQ character. And I read The Power of the Dog by Thomas Savage for this prompt. In the month of June, I joined Golden Girls Readathon and I chose Team Sophia. Team Sophia actually won this round and I'm very proud to be a part of the winning team, of course. There were common prompts as well as Team Sophia prompts. I read 1 or 2 books for each prompt. The first common prompt was to read a book set or published in 80s or 90s. I read Uyku by Haruki Murakami, which was set in 1980s. For reading a book with a strong female-male character, I read The Preacher's Unexpected Bride by Catherine Kennedy. I reread two favorite books. One of them was The Sleeping Merger by Agatha Christie and the other one was Zübük by Aziz Nesin. The fourth prompt was the same as the Golden Girls Reading Challenge. By and about someone who identifies as LGBTQIA+, I read The Power of Dog by Thomas Savage. And the last common prompt was a book you think your girl would read. I read Semaver by Faith Saik Abasyanık. I thought, although Sophia likes to tell long, long stories, I don't think she has the patience to read long stories. So Semaver, this short story collection was ideal for her. For Team Sophia prompts, for the book that includes a recipe, I read Dying for Danish by Leyhan Dobbs. For oldest book on my shelf, I read Villette by Charlotte Bronte. For S on the cover, I read one short story and one book from a theology, The Silent Sister by Diane Chamberlain and The Broken String by Diane Chamberlain again. For a mystery or a thriller book, I read The Widow by Fiona Barton. And the last prompt was to read a book by an immigrant author. I read Mouse by Art Spiegelman. So Golden Girls Readathon was a big success for me in the month of June. And last but of course not least, I also participated in June on the Range Readathon with just one book, which was the book that I used for everything actually. The Power of the Dog by Thomas Savage. It was a Western historical fiction book. So this was my June wrap-up part 3. Please comment down below. What was your favorite book that you read in June? Mine was Warbreaker by Brandon Sanderson. And if you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! As for Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose immigrant. Immigrant means göçmen in Turkish and göçmen is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!